We have a warning for you if you spend a lot of time outdoors. Experts say the tick population could boom this year.
And right now, the most dangerous ones are all over the place. 11 News reporter George Lettuce looks into this uptick.
In 2010, several states, including neighboring Virginia, saw huge spikes in the number of tick-related illnesses. Maryland was at its average number, but for this year, officials here are concerned.
Mark Kaplan in Hereford, Baltimore County says lately 2 to 3 patients a week come in with Lyme disease. He already considers 2011 a bad year for ticks.
Yes, it is, and it goes along with the fact that there's so many deer. The deer carry it.
And the ticks bite infected deer and then move on to other mammals. Maryland typically sees more than 1,000 tick-borne illnesses a year, but the weather we've had so far this year provides a perfect environment for a spike in ticks and Lyme disease.
A warm winter would certainly contribute to more ticks surviving, and then ticks really need moisture in order to survive, so certainly a wet spring would contribute to increased tick populations.
And experts say tick season is at its peak right now because the deer tick is in what's called the nymphal stage of its life cycle.
The nymphal stage of the tick, which is the second stage in the tick life cycle, is the stage of the tick most frequently associated with transmission of Lyme disease. And one of the reasons for this is that it is so small. It is really challenging to see on your body. It is smaller than a sesame seed. And so it is critical if someone's been out in tick habitat to do a really thorough tick check.
So if you're often outside in rural areas, wear light-colored clothing to spot the ticks easier, and take a shower when you get back inside.
Lyme disease can look like, it can have 50 different ways of presenting itself.
So the bottom line here is, if you think you got bitten by a tick, or you have some strange red spots on your body, go see a doctor. In Baltimore County, George Lattice, WBAL-TV 11 News.
In case you didn't know, the experts say your breakfast could help repel ticks. The CDC recently found part of grapefruits can help, but you don't rub the fruit on yourself. You can learn how scientists are testing new products on WBALTV.com. Be sure to click on Medical Alert.